You know, I could say, okay, I'm gonna be good to Brother Rico, and I'm gonna give him a check for $1,000. I'm just talking, don't tell him. Give him a check for $1,000. And, well, who said what now? Somebody said something? Because I'll need help on that contribution. But that's not goodness.
No.
That's being good to my brother.
Right.
But goodness is a spirit that I generate.
Yes.
And I show the goodness of Christ.
Yes.
And I have that good, I generate a quality that's beneficial. In other words, my goodness is that I might be beneficial to you.
Being good to somebody.
And beneficial to the body of Jesus Christ. Goodness. How many are with me on these traits right now?
Yes. Amen. Amen. Yes. Amen.
If your mind wandering, I hope it's not.
Being good to be
praised. Being good.
What, giving him a $1,000 check is being generous. That's generosity.
Generosity, yes.
Goodness.
You're right.
Goodness would sometimes be with all that $1,000.
Absolutely.
Amen.
You're right. Thank you for finishing that thought for me, and because that's exactly what I meant.
That's right.
I get him in trouble.
That giving him that $1,000 might not be good.
Right.
Withholding that $1,000 might be better.
Yes.
And better for him.
Amen.
And then he can have some goodness in his heart and give me $1,000. That's generosity.
Amen.
But goodness is for me to hold his hands up.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Pray for him.
Yes.
And hold him up in his heart. Next one is faith.
Faith.
Now I'm going to throw a little. You know, faith is not just having confidence.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Can't see God without this.
But faith is the confidence or a confident belief. This is what faith is. I'm reading this off my notes.
Okay.
Is to maintain a confident belief and trust in the Word of God, despite any challenging situations or conditions.
Right.
That's faith. Did you get grasp what I just said?
Amen.
Faith is to have confidence in that Word of God,
yes,
regardless,
yes,
of the situation.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Faith.
That's right.
Somebody, I might be going through something, and I'm telling you, I am going through something. You pray for me.
Yes.
I am. I'm praying for. Pray for me. I'm going through a hard situation. But my faith in the Word of God lets me know that at the end result, if I maintain joy, love, long suffering, then the end result will be, thus saith the Word of God.
Yes. Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise your name,
Lord.
Praise your name.
That's faith.
Yes.
Yes.
That's faith. Now you might have a basic elementary belief, confidence. You know, it's so easy for Christians to stand up and say, I have faith in God.
Yes.
I have faith and believe, I believe in God. I believe God's going to work out everything. And you know what? Some things God's not going to work out.
That's right. That's right.
Amen.
You're going to have the understanding through the Word of God.
Yes.
To overcome those things.
Yes. Come on.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. How many are hearing what I'm saying? Because your faith is dependent upon the depth of your understanding of the Word of God.
Hallelujah.
That's why we're sitting in this building today, so we can attain more faith. Blessed be the Lord.
Faith comes by hearing.
Yes. Paul the Apostle made that statement in the book of Romans, 10th chapter, I believe it is. He said, faith cometh by hearing. And hearing comes by what?
The Word of God.
The Word of God. So what that hearing must not be talking about this. And hearing must be talking about a true understanding.
Yes. Working in your life.
Faith cometh by hearing, that is an understanding of the Word of God.
Yes, I understand. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
And how can you hear? God's so good to us, isn't he?
Yes.
God's good to us. And how can he hear or understand without what?
A preacher.
Bible said that. I didn't say that.
Amen.
Don't throw anything at me, please. I didn't say that. The Bible said that.
Yes. Amen. It's a condition after that.
Yep. I'm not elevating myself. You ought to know better than that anyway. Mm-hmm. I'm not elevating myself.
No.
How then shall they call on him whom they have not believed? That is, how can you have believe in God if you don't understand, don't have some understanding?
Yeah, amen.
Yes.
You have to have an understanding of the Word of God.
Amen.
I don't understand, Brother Zonfeld, why God didn't answer this prayer. Sit down and learn.
Yes, yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Because you won't ask for some of the things that you're asking for now.
That's right.
Because sometimes the Lord throws things in your path. To bring you to a condition in your life that who you are.
That's right.
Yeah.
A child of God. All right, let's see. And how shall they believe in him whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a preacher? Now, next verse is very important too, since we're dealing with this series of verses. How shall they preach except they be sent? Sent by who?
God.
Sent by the higher up?
No. Well, it is. Yeah.
Well, yeah, you know what I mean.
I know it.
You know what I mean.
Or sent by man higher or a higher up.
Or sent because he went to a seminary somewhere?
College.
Or cemetery?
Yep.
Same or as college? No, sir. Man's tried to do everything to get preachers in the pulpit. Tried to manufacture them. Tried to produce them out of colleges. But do you know what? If God doesn't send them, then they're not really what you would call a preacher. Do they just all of a sudden they feel the urge to preach and they get out and preach and go out and preach? Is that the way they did it? No. You know what Paul did? He took young men and he worked them.
Yeah. Amen, amen, amen.
And they ran errands for him.
Mm-hmm. He taught them. He did that with Timothy.
And they took care of Paul's needs at times. They took messages. They took letters across the across the continent.
Had to be careful where they went with them.
Until God put the Word of God into their spirit and into their lives.
Amen. Yes.
Because they are messengers.
Amen.
Of God's Word.
Amen.
How can he preach the Word of God except he has the understanding? Well, the Holy Ghost will give him understanding when he's standing behind the pulpit. No, it doesn't work that way. Where do these men in this work? There might be preachers being developed right here in this assembly.
That's right.
But, you know, they might have a feeling and an urge to preach. But if they're wise, they'll sit down and they'll listen.
Yes.
And they'll be taught the Word of God.
Yes.
Because when they exercise, they won't have to lean upon experiences alone. But they can dictate the Word of God.
Mm-hmm.
One scripture.
Yep.
ties upon another scripture.
Yes.
Bible said, hear a little and dare a little. Line upon line, precept upon precept. It's study. Paul sent to Timothy, and he set him down. He said, Timothy, study. To show thyself approved.
Amen.
First Timothy, Second Timothy, Titus are pastoral books. It tells how ministers should develop. And God's going to have a ministry rise up in this day. That's going to be absolutely phenomenal.
Amen.
They're going to rise up. Because we're living in a chaotic time. It's going to get worse. People will shoot you for a dollar. If they don't agree with the system of the legal system, they'll rise up. They'll go in a city and destroy it. You know that if we had an uprising like that in the city of Sebring, our police force would not be able to handle it. They'll be tearing up buildings, but you know the next phase that's coming, they're going to go from house to house. We're living in a real time. You know what it is? It's the end time.
Right. Amen.
But right in the midst of it, Jesus is coming.
Yes,
and I want to be ready when he comes.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise your name.
Let me prepare my life. Let me prepare my heart. Let me set my mind. Let me hold on.
Yes.
Let me be taught. Let me hear the word of God.
Yes. Yes.
Oh, hallelujah. Let it become a part of my life. Let it become me. Praise God. Let me be a living epistle, read and known of all men. Praise the name of the Lord. Next one is meekness. Meekness is to be completely submissive to the word of God without resistance or doubt. Woo! You might sit there and say, how do I know that man is preaching the truth? How do I know that? You know what that is? That's doubt. But you know, God can clear that up in your mind. If you just start praying, praising the Lord, being faithful, hearing him out, let him preach to me. And here's a measure that you can measure it with. Is he preaching doctrine of a society? Is he preaching doctrine of religion? Is he preaching doctrine of a Protestant movement? Or is he preaching the doctrine out of the Bible? Blessed be the Lord.
Amen.
Because the Holy Ghost will give you that understanding.
Yes, amen.
And then you'll sit with the spirit of meekness. And you'll receive what that man of God says. Or you'll receive what that assembly is doing, what that church is doing. I want to be a part, not of a movement. I want to be a part of the church of the living God.
Yes. Amen, amen.
I want to be a part of God's movement in this earth right now. Praise the name of the Lord. I'm glad that this assembly has broken down all the shackles of religious society. And we're sitting here with meekness for the Holy Ghost to come in and bless us. We're in submission to God. We sit here with a submissive spirit, a spirit that's teachable. If I know it all, and you know, that can happen to you because, especially in this body of people, you can be so pumped up with knowledge that you don't know a thing.
Amen.
Blessed be the Lord. Did you hear what I said?
Yes.
Let me look in the camera. You can be pumped up with knowledge and not know a thing.
Amen.
Isn't that right?
Amen.
You can.
Amen.
But I want to be humble.
Yes.
And submissive. Because God is teaching the church today. To be easily led to do and perform all things that are right and pleasing in the sight of God.
Yes, amen.
My goodness, what a spirit that is. I'm not telling you these spirits are easy to put on. I'm not telling you that because there's going to have to be a self-denial.
Right.
There's going to have to be, you're going to have to do things sometime for the Lord that you really don't want to do.
Amen.
You might have to get dressed on a Friday night and say, I've got to be in church.
Yes.
But I don't feel like it. But I've got to.
Yes.
I've got to be there.
Yes.
Because I want to grow.
Amen.
I want to mature in the Lord Jesus Christ. Next one and last one is temperance. Temperance is to exercise a balance of moderation in all things according to the word of God.
Right.
Not my feelings or emotions, but according to the word of God. The ability to exercise self-restraint. Woo! That's tough, isn't it? You ever been in a situation, you know, I've been in a situation where, man, I'd get, you ever been like that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
If you're honest, you'll shake your head yes. You're
honest.
But I didn't say anything to the person, you know. Never said nothing to him, though, you know, I'm still a good boy.
I probably.
You probably did.
That's an honest heart, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
But to have a temperate heart is learning to exercise restraint.
Right. Like tempered steel.
Restrain. Woo. Who? S-E-L-F. Self. Restrain. I don't know if I can do that. Well, then I don't know if you're going to be in the bride of Christ.
Amen.
Huh? Right?
Amen. You got to have it.
Can you say amen
to that? Amen. Amen.
I've got to have restraint. And do you know that we, as people normally do, we have put things on the shelf. You heard that expression, haven't you? You don't get it, put it on the shelf. And do you know that my shelf, I'm having to stabilize my shelf, put a couple of tubifores under it because it's really getting full.
Yes.
But do you know that it is time for us to pull things
off the shelf?
Because a lot of things we put on the shelf was not because we didn't understand it. It's because we just weren't ready to do it.
Yes.
Can you say amen?
Amen. Amen.
When we put it on that shelf.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Man, that shelf gets so heavy, you know.
Yes, it does.
That shelf is like that, you know. So I had to put a tubifore under it. Tubifore. That's another carnal conception, and I put it under there. But. And some of these things we put. Well, when I get far enough in God, then all of these things will come. Huh? Really? Have we done that? All of those things that we know to do, well, yeah, we're going to do them when we get to God, you know. But I'm not ready right now yet. Let me go back to the second coming of Jesus. Praise God. Let's dig into that. Oh, goodness, let's go to the 1 Thessalonians, the 4th chapter, and let's dig into that. Go to Ephesians, and let's dig into the second coming of Jesus, and go into Corinthians 15 and find out all of those goodies about that. You know why? Because it didn't stir me. It didn't go against my grain. Didn't go against it. It didn't war against it. It was wonderful to hear those things, but do you know that put a hope in my life? Now I'm to take those things off the shelf and say, I need to learn how to be temperate.
Amen.
Yeah.
How to have a balanced spirit in my life.
Yeah.
Yep.
How to keep myself from being angry all the time. Or be miserable all the time. Or be envious all the time. Or have pride all the time. God, help me to overcome that. You know, we stand there, we pray, God help us, and we look at the distance of Jesus Christ, and that's what he is. He's distant from us, but do you know what? He is not distant from us. He's within us, praise the Lord. He's the hope of our glory. He's the hope of our eternal life. He is with us. He dwells with us. Oh, hallelujah. I can feel him right now. He's with us. He's with us.
Yes.
All we got to do is allow him to help us.
Right.
You know, sometimes we pray because we want the outcome to be our outcome.
Right. We pray amiss.
But those empty prayers do not give us anything. But as we learn how to exercise, have the ability to restrain ourselves. You know what's going to happen? And somebody says, but you know what? I don't believe I can do that. Well, you're minimizing God.
Right.
Yes, you are. Sure.
Amen.
You're minimizing Jesus Christ.
Yes.
There's one thing that I would like to really impress on this congregation is that Christ is in you.
Yes.
He dwells with you.
Yes.
He's there with you.
Yes.
You can't do it by yourself.
No.
You can't do it yourself.
No.
It isn't going to be you that does it. It's going to be Christ
Amen.
In you.
Yes.
The praises of God extended to him. You know what we need to do? We need to praise God. We might be missing something in our spirit, but do you know what? We need to praise God and say we claim it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus, I'm going to claim an overcoming life. I'm going to claim a spirit of temperance. I'm going to claim the spirit of love. I'm going to claim the spirit of righteousness. I'm going to claim the overcoming life. Blessed be the Lord, because I've got him in me. The hope of glory. Blessed be the Lord. There's more power in his name. I feel the Holy Ghost right now. I'm going to repeat myself if I'm not careful, but I don't care because I believe this is strength from God. He is with us. He is with us. Praise the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
Thank you,
Lord.
I hear the word of God, and there's a picture that's drawn in my mind. And in my spirit, and I correlate it with my natural self. But you know what? What God's trying to help us do is overcome this natural self.
Yes.
Yes.
Amen.
The Bible said that natural guy has to die.
Yes, it does.
If you try to overcome with the natural guy, you're not overcoming.
No. Yeah.
And you're not going to overcome.
No.
But if we let God help us, that the Holy Ghost is not just an experience that we received at an altar, but the Holy Ghost is the very essence of life in your life, in your spirit. Blessed be the Lord. And the Word of God is a perfect picture of what God wants us to be. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And through the Holy Ghost, we can be more than conquerors. Blessed be the Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Power.
Amen.
And you know what? Your conquering of your flesh don't start with the mountain. Start with the bottom of the mountain. Start with the little things. God can help you. God will help you. If you practice what I'm telling you today, God will help you. It's learning how to let God help you.
Yes.
You've got to become dependent and believe what you have is real.
Yes.
How many believe what you have in your life is real?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Do you believe that Jesus Christ in your life is real?
Amen.
Yes, he is.
If not, have the guts. Well, that's pretty plain talk, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Have the guts Don't worry, I'm not going to. Have the guts to get up from where you're sitting.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
And walk up.
Yes.
And have the nerve to say, Jesus, I need him fully in my heart and in my life. It's not that we're putting you on the scene, but the Lord wants you to know, the Lord wants to know where you're at.
Yes, he does.
And what position you take in this great move that God's moving in the church right now. God, help me. Help me. I need you more than anything in my heart and in my life.
Amen.
Everything is secondary.
That's yes. Right. Amen.
Amen.
It's got to be.
Praise your name.
You've got to be able to leap over buildings and jump over
what?
Let's see, it says something about leaping over buildings and... Oh, that's right. Leaping over a wall and running through a troop. You know, God can help us to do that. The greatest wall in your life can be the wall of non-acceptance of what this church, what the Lord's trying to show you. There can be a big wall there. But God can help you today to leap over that wall.
Yes.
Rejection.
And then there's a troop of opposition that's against you.
Yes.
You know, that's really the truth.
Yeah, amen.
A child of God stands there and there is a troop coming against him.
Yes.
Is that right, John? Everything wars against your soul.
Yes.
Everything tries to take you out of the picture of serving God. Everything against you, but the Holy Ghost, praise God, can give you power to run through that troop.
Right.
Praise the Lord. Oh, I feel God here today.
Amen.
That's the, that is the nine fruit of the Spirit, or rather the nine attributes of the fruit of the Spirit.
No longer is
that. A man of God, rather a man or a woman that stands, in, that becomes a fruit.
Yeah, amen.
A product of what God's trying to produce in the earth right now will have these nine attributes working in our hearts,
amen,
in our lives. How many want to be?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Do you want to have that in your heart and in your
amen
life? I pray that you do. Because if you have that attribute working in your life, you can be the most effective individual in the city of Sebring. And you can bring children of God into the work of the Lord. There are people out in this community that are looking for a church that is preaching the truth, that's got their hearts open for it. Praise God. There's some that have even come against this assembly. But do you know what? God can turn them around and bring them right back to the house of the living God. Hallelujah. God can do that. You can't do that. God can't do that. But God can do that. Praise the Lord. We might have opposition against a person that come against the church. But let me tell you something. That is going down the drain. Because God is wanting us to have an open heart. Praise God for all of God's people. Praise God.
Eternal fall around.
Boy, I felt the Lord on that.
Amen.
Somebody's coming, sister. Yes. Lottie, somebody's coming. Going to test us, you know.
Yes.
But you know what? I feel like God's going to help us to have the right spirit.
Yes, amen.
Going to have the right spirit.
There's a key.
Because they're still a child of God, no matter how much they hate you.
Yes.
they're still a child of God.
That's right.
Have to have the right attitude, the right spirit. You know what? If we put on these nine wonderful characteristics, how many got something out of the lesson today?
Yes, Lord.
These nine wonderful characteristics. Oh, God. My heart goes out to you for that puppy. I'm praying, God. Bring that puppy home, God.
Hallelujah.
Bring that puppy home. Because God can do that.
Yes, he can.
Somebody said, that's a dog, Brother Zonnebell. But you don't know. You don't know. That little Yorkie that I have, man, I love him to pieces. And he can be ornery at sometimes. But do you know when Daddy goes out that door, he stands at the window waiting for him to come home.
Yes,
it's a dog. And there's, yes, it's an unconditional love. But God can help us today.
Yes.
He can help us.
Amen.
I'd like for us to sing a chorus, Sister June. I don't have one on mine, but maybe you do. But I'd like to sing a chorus of Reaching Jesus. I felt the Holy Ghost in the choruses that we sang. Reaching Jesus. How many want more of Jesus? I want more
and more
of Jesus. Praise the name of the Lord. More of Jesus. God can help us.
Yes.
God is helping us.
Yes.
Can you say glory with me?
Glory.
God is helping us. I feel like we need to sing this chorus right now. Let's not hinder the Spirit. Let's go ahead and sing this chorus. Let's reach out to Him right now and let the Holy Ghost come in. Praise the name of the Lord. Everyone in this place. Praise God. And believe that God can touch you in a greater measure than what you've ever had. It doesn't matter what your life was in the past. It doesn't matter what you're holding on to. Just let go of it. And turn your heart and life over to Jesus. Let's sing it some more. Yes, Lord.
Yeah.
There is only one.
Feel the Holy Spirit over here. Praise God.
Praise God.
Praise God.
Hey,
Jesus.
I am in Jesus.